Well, I can safely say this is the day I've been dreading the most. And how long is it going to take for me to trigger this fight, by the way? I have hit him so many times, leads me to believe that I'm going to have more of a bloody hard time starting this fight. Oh, there you go! That's a reasonable amount of damage! And I just pressed the A button to roll before realizing I forgot how to play this game. Almost died immediately. Your plan doesn't really make all too much sense. I mean, I understand separating yourself from Lysandra so she can't take over you or whatever nonsense you were fearing, but I'm seeing a really big sword in your hand right about now. Why don't you just apply that to her neck and just be done with it? I'm pretty sure that could have easily worked. I know she's your wife and everything, but in the bounds of holy matrimony, I don't think it's really all too kosher when she's a fucking demon of the abyss. How did that not get me? I would say that'd give me a haircut, but just got clipped up against the goddamn wall. That's kind of my fault. Should have been paying attention to that. That's on me. Why is that door misted up? I do believe that door is not supposed to be misted up. Oh, that's why. Because the game's playing silly bollocks. Alright, then I have nothing else equipped. Come on, I'll fight you with a ladle. Where are you? There you are. For some reason, the game spawns you miles away from me. I am using a ladle. If you'd like to give some sort of mercy, that'd be appreciated. But seeing as you're using that weapon, I'm not expecting it at all. Especially now I can see your aura. Oh, lovely. You know, I've just got the most wonderful feeling about everything in my life right about now, because this is really a crystallizing moment of, yeah, this is going to be fan-diddly-tastic. I'm just going to do this forever, because that way I can resign to my fate. There you go. You just used one of the most cheesiest weapons against a man using a ladle. May that be written in the histories of your name. Massive cum-guzzling cunt. Exhibit A through Z. Executed a man trying to fight the king with a ladle with your wonderful spinny spear of shit. I don't know if the histories will record and remember that, but I know I fucking will. But yeah, to be completely honest with you, I was really disappointed when I found you for what you were. I was expecting some grand, glorious, lumbering giant in plated armor and all that shit. And what I got was a naked man. I've got to tell you, I've been fighting naked men the entire way here. They're not really all too interesting, unfortunately. And seeing as you managed to possess a slower speed than a Romero-style zombie, you really don't really bring all too much to the table. You know, I completely get it. You were trying to separate yourself from Lysandra, so her quest to rule the world would be hindered. But here's the thing I don't get. I understand putting yourself through all the obstacles so she couldn't find you with the Milfinito and all that bullshit so she couldn't actually ever get anywhere near you. But why did you do something so amazingly unproductive? Could you have not have maybe made more of an effort to do something with your final act instead of just wandering around in a crypt over and over again? I mean, seriously, is that really a scene befitting for a king? You know, I thought this boss fight was going to be all smiles and ice cream when I got you to half health, and I realised, oh wait, I can still be really fucking stupid, don't worry, still got that box ticked, managed to roll right the fuck into the hilt of the sword. Oh, and you're starting the fight off with a jumping attack. Are you a fan of Looking Glass Knights at all? Could you please come over here? I mean, seriously, the giant lord was more imposing than you. Just a thing. A thing that fell in the war was more imposing than the king that actually won the war. I'm serious. If the giant lord was that imposing and that successful in a one-on-one fight with me, and yet you're not, how the fuck did you win? I mean, I know it wasn't like you were one-on-one-ing the entire freaking army of them, but how did an army of mini shitheads incapable of beating anything managed to best an entire army of giants? Well, don't worry, Vendrick. For all the negative things I have to say about you, I do sympathize with your situation. You basically got into cahoots with a gold digger that wanted to dig more than just your gold. You wanted your soul and your throne. That's the worst case scenario for anybody. I can sympathize with that, because I'm sure you were just a lonely king that wanted somebody to settle down with. And again, as soon as you got into a relationship with it, she thought you had a fucking war to go run off and fight, so I don't really think she had your best interests at heart. I mean, if one of the first meaningful interactions that you have with somebody is, hey, I've got a war for you to fight for me, you probably shouldn't be all too trusting of them. Because it's one of two things. They're either trying to put you into danger so you drop dead and they get everything, or they're trying to use you, and they're going to get you to do absolutely every single whim and want they have until the day you die. And in this case, it was actually kind of both. Because if the thing that you brought back from the land of the giants was the kiln and the throne, then not only did you want to put you in danger by just getting you to start a war with things that had absolutely zero problem with you beforehand, but she pretty much got you to go play a freaking fetch quest for her. Nobody likes those, Vendrick. The fact you willingly got thrown into one without even realising has got to be a real stinger. More than the 7,000 ladle hits onto your left knee. Agonising loneliness and... well... That's what I wanted to do! Bollocks! Can't believe I fucked that up. Can't believe it! You were probably like a dozen hits from death and I fucked it up. And I love how 3 hits there just completely whiffed behind your freaking knees. Love it. There's still a whole bunch that I don't get about your plan. I mean, let's put myself into the middle of the crypt and leave the ring right next to myself. So that way, when the deserving hollow comes along and the next monarch just fucking passes through, he can choose to kill me instead of just giving the fucking ring to Veldstadt so I could remain untouched and unfucking badgered. But no, apparently you wanted the Chosen Undead to just walk through here and see you lumbering around just doing absolutely nothing with yourself, with your clothes on the floor with the ring right there. Really makes me question a whole bunch about you, because I get it. Veldstadt was defending you. I don't, however, understand why you'd want him to drop dead, because if anybody made it that far, because nobody else ever seemingly did, and the Shandra couldn't get that far because of Northanita in the fucking shrine place. Shrine of... something. Shrine of Armana, that's it, right? That place. She couldn't even get past there. So there was absolutely zero reason for Veldstadt to have died defending you from me, which is the person you wanted to get to you anyway. I'm still pissed about that, by the way. When somebody is your right-hand man and you just willingly say, you know what, fuck it, you can just defend me from the thing I know that's going to kill you, so that way, fuck you. It's not like I set up all these obstacles in a way so that whenever somebody does try and come over to save the world from the bitch that nearly tried to rob me of everything, that, you know, he'd be strong enough to kill you. Fuck you, sorry, thanks for all your loyal service, I'm just gonna pretty much use you as another stepping stone to make my little pet a bigger boy. I mean, that's it. That's all you did. Why didn't you just tell the two people that were guarding the throne and your right-hand man that, hey, you know when this guy comes along, maybe you want to help him the fuck out? Because Nashandra's a bit of a problem, and she may fuck everything up for everyone instead of, I don't know, just letting me kill them? Because that's not really the best. I guess I can understand the hesitance to tell them anything lest Nashandra get wind of it, but I'm pretty sure she's wise to your bullshit at this point, fella. I'm pretty sure all lights are flashing. I'm pretty sure we're banging on all cylinders that she knows that you pissed off and didn't want to help her. Begs the question why the hell you wouldn't want anything else to help me. At no point. Dear Vendrick, did you ever set anything up to explicitly help me in the form of help? Sure, you made a bunch of obstacles for me to go through that make me stronger, but they were trying to kill me, so that wasn't necessarily help as it was, yeah, if you get through it, then good for you. Because if I've killed all the 4 old ones and all that shit at this point, maybe you should think if I get this far, you should just give faith to whoever makes it to this point. And then I could have some throne guardians to go and kick the shit out of the Shandra with me, and Veldstadt too. And that way, I've got people defending me from whatever hellish thing may come after me. I mean, hell, there's plenty of shards of Manis left just floating around in the abyss. I'm sure another part of him could just come out and fuck everything up for us. But you figured all your most loyal servants and subjects should just be subjected to death by me. I don't know. Doesn't make sense to me. Fucking hell! Seriously, Vendrick, if you can do all those jumps and shits, why don't you just, I don't know, kick back as a donkey would? Why don't you just do anything other than swing your sword in an arc that will never hit me? You know, I can't help but wonder what would have happened to you if Nashandra never came along. Because you were still fucking around every which way but loose trying to find a way to prolong your life in the flame itself. I'm curious what lengths you would have gone to have done that, because seemingly you replicated a dragon in the form of the Ancient Dragon, which is a mix of a giant soul and seemingly a dragon's. Well, how far would you have gone? To an extent, for all we know, Nashandra potentially saved us from whatever shit you would have done just to save yourself. I'm in no way saying that Nashandra is the savior we deserve. Far fucking from it. But maybe having to deal with her shit was a tad better than having to deal with whatever monstrosities you would have concocted to try and prolong your own goddamn existence. Again, I still don't understand why the hell you didn't just have Nashandra killed. Why would that have been such a horrible problem? It's like, hey, everyone in my land, this bitch is a bit of a problem, and she's trying to take over everything. Maybe if we just kill her, that would, I don't know, get rid of the problem, and then none of this shit would have happened to an extent. I mean, you'd have still turned hollow at some point. I know that would have happened. Completely understand. But maybe you could have killed the problem before you became a problem yourself. I mean, seriously. Maybe I'm just missing something obvious. But what was stopping you from just killing her? I mean, I know she's the queen and everything, but... you were the king, and she's trying to kill you. Is that not treason? Is that not punishable by death regardless of who the shit you are? I don't get it, you had all these defenses lined up. You had your right-hand man, you had throne defenders, and yet, You didn't hire an executioner so you could kill the bitch that's trying to kill you? Was your land bereft of all law? Was it just open season, regardless of your name and title? I think one of the benefits of being the king is you can just say, hey, cut that fucker's head off, because I say so. How would that not have solved all these problems? It's not as if she was immortal. I killed her. With a ladle. With the thing I'm killing you with right now. So please tell me, why the fuck you just didn't have her killed? And again, it's quite likely I've missed something obvious in that department. Maybe Nishandra convinced everybody around her that she was normal and Vendrick was nuts. I am serious about all this, Vendrick. I know I'm killing you, and I'm pretty much destroying all source of knowledge, if ever you even had a brain left in there in your hollowed husk of a nothing. But I would like that information. Why you didn't just have her killed, when you were completely safe. Oh well. Instead, you resigned yourself to be lonely in a crypt, and have all the people that followed you and loved you die by my hand, and then have me kill you and do everything you couldn't. It's embarrassing. A man with a ladle accomplished more than a king with a sword. Well, you can't say magic doesn't happen. I can't believe I actually subjected myself to that, and I can't believe how fucking often I failed. Really embarrassed about that. Really fucking embarrassed. I could have been done 20 minutes ago. That took me an entire 50 fucking minutes. Unbelievable! And that's the end of the video. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this, then don't forget to leave a like to broadcast the fact that you'd like to see more from this specific series. And if you enjoyed it to the point where you'd actually want to see more from this series, or this channel in general, then don't forget to share this video with your friends and subscribe so you don't miss out on any future installments. And should the sub boxes be failing you, as they do for most, then feel free to bookmark my video page and check back daily, as that's how often I provide content to you. Or alternatively, you could follow me on any respective social media service you should desire, as I update them all regularly with my videos, as this site isn't actually known to be good at doing its job. So, as always, your viewership and YouTube support will always be infinitely appreciated. And assuming you do indeed want to see more from me and the content I provide, then I will see you in the next video.